crazy weeks and crazy golden shows. We got cyber thieves. We got bombers buried. We also got frozen lakes in Minnesota. And sequesters got airplanes falling out the skies. And your boy Crippy got windowed falling on golden fingers. It's the Golden Debate Show. My man Tone's getting his work in. So I'm going to get my show in all by myself. The Golden Debate Show may or may not be moving to Thursdays, but we'll be getting that in another time. So let the hunt begin. I also want to say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there, because without the mothers, man, well, it's cliche, none of us will be here. I don't want to get into the importance of how I feel that the male and the female is equally important, but without the mothers, man, we need the mothers out there to be better than the males out there, man. You know, males are known for slipping up, not that that gives us a right to or whatever, but, you know, I'll just speak in my circumstance. My father's a way wilder man than my mother, so I want to give a shout out to my moms and a shout out to everybody's moms, because deep down the universe is a woman and God must be a man, and together it makes one holy union. But let's not get into that, because I don't want to lose people. That's when we start losing people. Remember, the vampires want one race, one religion, so that they could dominate. I want everybody to be one golden sanction so we can all live golden. Like, comment, share, and download earlymorningmob.com, the Golden Debate Show, number 13. I usually skip numbers like that because the vamps like to use them numbers. But we're going to beat them with their own numbers and numerology. Golden Debate Show. I'm going to do my best to do the show by myself once again. Your boy Kryptonite, earlymorningmob.com. Let's get into it. So let the hunt begin for the truth against vampires and against big media.
Find this ratio all over people's faces, because it applies to the idealized human form.
Science.
On which scientists and
artists agree. Shut up already. It's just, this is science.
The rest of what is golden ratio from last show.
Average human body is that when the distance between
got a good show lined up. Let's go, golden show. Peace to all the moons.
The height of a human being is equivalent to 1.6.
Moon is the feminine.
Some other golden proportions in the average human body.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
Two different stories.
The distance between the fingertip and the elbow. The distance between the wrist and the elbow. The distance between the shoulder line and the top of the head.
Science! Okay.
The distance between the navel and the top of the head. The distance between the shoulder line and the top of the head.
Backflash. 1.
The distance.
Chapter 1. When the car stopped rolling, Michael kicked out the rest of the windshield and crawled through onto the wrinkled dirt, locked first. He slid to the left, around the tree that had made the Seville finally jolt to a stop, and listened.
Go to Debate Show, EverymorningMob.com!
These woods held a shock silence.
What? Like, comment, share, and download. Every animal. Remember, don't be a pussy and follow everybody else. Keep an open mind, not an empty one.
Nobody came down the hill, following the scar through the trees. There was just the one car in pursuit up there. Federal agents of some kind. Probably trying right now to make radio contact with the rest of their crew, and still chasing the truck with the rockets, figuring they'd come back to the wrecked car later. Later was good enough for Parker. He eased around the train and then to move down the less battered right side of the Seville, where he'd been seated next to the driver. The glass from that window was gone. He looked in at Howell at the wheel, and Howell looked back, his eyes scared, but his mouth twisted in what was supposed to be an ironic grin.
They clamped me,
he said, and shook his head. Parker looked at him.
Singer Katy Perry, the big-breasted, bisexual, Babylonian bimbo.
What? Mark Dice has done it again.
Encouraging her young.
Go to debaters.
To make out with each other and sexually experiment with friends.
Remember, folks, this guy's a vampire himself.
Our own father, Keith Perry.
Well, that's just my observation.
Heads up in the church.
Called the week.
Daughter, a devil child, he asks the congregation to please pray for her, and said that he cries every time he goes to her concert because he sees I stood there and I wept, and I kept on weeping and weeping. They're loving and worshiping the wrong thing. That's pretty interesting because this guy her rise to fame.
Science.
Her single.
Okay. Shadow Party. It's just, this is science.
I wonder what he thought about this satanic serpent when she appeared on Sesame Street, the children's show, showing off her.
Hey, that's somebody's daughter.
I can't even imagine who in the right mind, the producers, just in Sesame Street would have been Babylonian bimbo. Yeah, let's get her and introduce her to the kids. The girl who's best known for her single, I Kissed a Girl. Yeah, let's get around Sesame Street.
And I believe that she liked it.
Trying to destroy the very mind of your children. That's why they want the government to raise your kids. So that you
get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
Two different stories.
What's right and wrong. Yeah, Barack Obama just said it was okay to give girls, you know, 15 years old, a morning after pill. And a lot of people just take kids to go get abortions without the parents' knowledge. And then the state knows best.
Science.
Big brother.
Okay. Shadow party. It's just, this is science.
System. What many people don't know is that Katy Perry used to be a gospel singer. But her career never took off.
That won't get you far.
So she said, out of her own mouth, I sold my soul to the devil.
Distraction of the
go check
week.
My video. Hey. Chemtrails. Sold to Satan when her gospel career just went flat, went stale. And here is this hoe wearing an Obama dress. Where is it?
Hey,
yeah, right before the 2012
science.
Election.
Okay.
You ain't got to scoop down to the damn level
science.
With the name calling.
Unless it's the big fans. You're frying the big fish.
The listening fans.
You vamp yourself, boy.
To vote for Barack Obama, the celebrity president. Of course, Jay-Z, the satanic scumbag, big fan of Aleister Crowley, appeared in official campaign ads for Obama. Jay-Z appeared as Obama's hype man on stage before campaign
stops.
Found
a picture from 1933 looking just like that motherfucker, and I gotta say, does kind of look like him.
Kind of
like the Nicolas Cage bit.
Some people call it music. His mainstream crap. Because Obama was
talking
stuff. Obama and Obama
said for quite some time. That
they used scumbags like Jay-Z
because of the pressure that we put
to
on
reach people
Al Qaeda corps
never watched the news.
Because of the pressure that we put on these networks
never watched the news. Because of the picture of everyone stand up
deserves their mac and cheese.
Project, transnational threats against the United States. One of the dangers that we now face are self-radicalized individuals who are already here in the United States. In some cases, may not be part of any kind of network, but because of whatever warped, twisted ideas they may have, may decide to carry out an attack. And those are, in some ways, more difficult to prevent. And so what I've done for months now is to indicate to
typing
our
in the
entire
back. Typing in the
terrorism
back.
Team, what more can we do on that threat that is looming
okay.
on the horizon.
Shut up,
there more
it's
things
just
that
science.
We can do, whether it's engaging with communities where there's a potential for self-radicalization of this sort. Is there
get
work
that mac
can be
and
done
cheese, everybody
in terms of detection?
Deserves their mac and cheese.
But all of this has to be done in the context of our laws, due process.
in the moments after these hearings.
And so who's lost? The van lost?
Doing that is going to be to see if we can determine any lessons learned.
Just to reset exactly how authorities were tipped off that these three, I don't want to say involved, but have information regarding after these bombs went off here on Boylston Street. We know they were taken in, they were questioned, there were some student visa issues, and then now facing federal charges. Take me back to the very beginning, if you will.
Well, at the very beginning, Brooke, you know, they were rounded up on April 19th, which was the day that Jahar Tsarnaev was captured. They were rounded up from their residence near the UMass Dartmouth campus in New Bedford. It was the two suspects, the first two suspects, the Kazakhstan students, and another person were rounded up. They were brought in for questioning. They were then released that night because of a lack of evidence. They were then taken into custody again over that weekend, either on the 20th or the 21st, and the two Kazakhstan
early
students,
to the morningmob.com Golden Debate Show number 13 with your boy Crypt the Night, holding it down solo, like, comment, share, and download.
Visa violations. They violated the allegedly violated the student visas somewhere by not going to class. Now they have been held since that time. And they had an immigration hearing even this morning, after which they were detained. So we have always gotten the impression, since they were taken into custody on those charges, the visa immigration charges.
I had no knowledge of these attacks, nor do I consider the killing of innocent women, children, and other humans as an appreciable act. Islam strictly forbids causing harm to innocent women, children, and other people. Such a practice is forbidden, even in the course of a battle. And that quote comes from Osama bin Laden and was made on September 28th, 2001. Welcome to Surviving the Matrix, ladies and gentlemen.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
It's a pleasure to be with you once again.
Science.
And I will be your host.
Shut up, Marty. This is science.
Well, my friends, the news of the day is certainly the alleged killing of Osama bin Laden by a United States SEAL team one of the United States' illegal excursions into Pakistan.
Oh,
United
yeah,
States
remember that distraction?
Has been carrying out illegal bombing raids against Pakistan since as far back as 2005, and possibly even earlier. This is, of course, without war ever being declared upon Pakistan, so they've just been sort of going in there and indiscriminately bombing another country. And even though a lot of these raids have been conducted by the military, there's very little doubt that these are, in fact, covert CIA operations.
And
the CIA's main agenda has always been stirring up tension around the world and paving the way for military and economic takeovers by the banking cartel that controls the United States government.
Hello, everybody.
All carried out, of course, as always, under the guise of spreading freedom to the world. Yes, folks, it's amazing how free pieces are when they have bombs dropped on them. Frees them from pretty well everything, doesn't it? Including life itself. Good old democratic freedom. Now, folks, this alleged killing of Osama bin Laden is almost too predictable. It's almost as if what's going on in life at the moment is turning into a B-grade.
Time for
movie.
The song of the day.
At least they tried to keep it A-grade for a little while. But
get that mac and cheese, everybody.
Science
deserves their mac and cheese.
Shut up, Marty.
As I've said
science.
Before, and as so many people have said, Osama bin Laden has been dead for a very long time, probably about 10 years. It's very likely that he died in December 2001.
Get that mac and cheese, everybody. Deserves their mac and cheese.
Science! Science! Two different stories.
Go to the debate show. Yeah. Livinglove.com.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese. I see the temperature change more from night to day. But it's the wrong way to think about it. I mean, think about when you get sick and you get a fever. Okay? Your body is usually at 90.7 degrees.
Hello, everybody.
Your temperature rises by 1 degree. You feel a little warm. But you can still go to work. It rises by 2 degrees. And you're now feeling sick. In fact, you're probably going to take the day off because you definitely don't feel good. And in fact, you're getting everything from hot flashes to cold chills. Okay? At 3 degrees, you're starting to get really sick. And at 4 degrees and 5 degrees, your brain is actually slipping into a coma. Okay? You're close to death. I think there's an analogy here of that little difference in global average temperature, just like that little difference in global body temperature. Can have huge implications.
To the extent that your question is, what can we do to make a higher profile for this issue, meetings like
Hello, everybody.
And occasions like this actually answer that question. For quite a while, we've been timid about standing up for what we know the scientific facts to be. I think we got knocked down by a very powerful propaganda campaign by the polluting industries. As you pointed out, the weather changes that we've seen, the sea level changes, have pushed back the public opinion so that the propaganda campaign is, I think, of less and less effect. And now I think it's our task to try to make sure that climate change.
Next clip is from my boy James Power from YouTube. He has the Meta Channel.
And
he breaks
gay rights
down nice, you know.
As an issue where the
He's
Republicans see that if they stick with this, they're going to run off the cliff
James
like lemons.
Here, and I just want to welcome you back to the Meta Channel and Meta TV, where today what we're going to do is we're going to talk about a subject called the moms, okay? The moms, the murder of our mother's sons, all right? That's going to be part one, and then part two is going to be the murder of Malcolm Shabazz. So it's the Moms Culture Shock Weekend. Happy Mother's Day, first of all, to my mother, Sheila Diane West, or born Sheila Diane West. She died as my... With today, what we're going to do is...
How you
going to
glitch on my Mother's Day parade?
The Moms, okay? The Moms. The
still going to get golden. Golden debate show.
They
come and share and download.
Right?
We do it even
That's
with glitching.
That's part one. And then part two is going to be the murder of my Malcolm Shabazz.
Everybody. Here about myself and everything. Still giving it
to
gold.
First of all, to my mother, Sheila Diane West. Born Sheila Diane West. She died as Mashallah Muhammad But she was born Sheila Diane West on 7/26 of 1951, made the transition on May the 3rd of 2008. So this is the 5-year anniversary of my mother's passing away. So I just want to say I love you, Mom. You know what I mean? And I want to put that out there. The second thing I want to say is happy birthday to the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. He turned 80 years old. He's been 55 years in the game, you know, of working to really help black people to kind of wake up to the time and what we must do for ourselves. A lot of us just assume that because black people in America who were up from slavery got out of so-called chattel slavery, that we got everything back. But they don't understand that when we were brought over here, our God was taken, gods, plural, were taken, our name was taken, our
very
language
true.
Was taken,
it
our
goes beyond
was
race,
taken.
But very
any
true.
Any kind of knowledge of self and kind was taken, and then, as if that wasn't enough, we were separated from our family. So some really dastardly stuff happened to us, okay? And so the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan is, of course, doing it in his own way, you know what I mean, with the Nation of Islam. This is their newspaper, the new newspaper, What is the Truth About UFOs? There was just a hearing in D.C. with respect to the whole UFO situation, a paper that people don't read enough. And, you know, I just want to say thank you to the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, thank you to the Nation of Islam for the work that they have done over the many years, okay?
Illuminati.com, the greatest debate is
celebrate great work, okay? And there's nothing wrong with that, alright? The second thing that I want to say is this video is not for everybody, alright? Parental advisory, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You have to have
with everything in this world
and your big boy that, pants brother. To watch this particular video. So I'm going to say it like this. If the glove don't fit, watch somebody else's ish, okay? Alright? So we're gonna go in hard. We're gonna go in heavy today.
Another more calm down, spiritual, metaphysical
example that I used one time on the Meta Channel. And I keep.
I know
paper
a lot of people
to
want
it.
To send blankets or is, water.
Remember
just send your cash.
And remember the little girl that was on the paper. Some of y'all can kind of see that young lady that's standing there. You see what I'm saying? You don't see. You look at a newspaper like this, but you get a snapshot of what's going on. But you don't know this little girl and the pain. You don't know this little girl and the anguish. You don't know this little girl and the suffering. You don't know this little girl and the transition that has taken place in her life because of the events that she went through, okay? And so to expect her to act and respond to life like you act and respond to life, I would dare say is just a little naive and a little short-sighted.
Fucking bogus.
And so when I say some of the things that I'm going to say today, even though I'm going to try to put them in a way that you,
science.
That I hope that you would
okay.
get it, that
Shut
I hope
up.
That you would understand, everybody's not necessarily going to understand this. How does it relate to spirituality? How does it relate to metaphysics, okay? The question that we have to ask is, our world is changing, but how is it changing, okay? One of the aspects of light that we don't want to get into really, but it's
mac and cheese,
okay? And so if you don't enlighten me because you kind of get the light of truth and you rise up on the pearly light of truth, fire got to be put up under your backside, burn your butt a little bit.
I know
and
a lot of people want to send
okay?
blankets
so
or water.
What's going on in the world.
Just
so
send your cash.
I know a lot we're going to discuss Charles Ramsey. We're going to discuss the Bangladesh situation. We're going to discuss a lot of this stuff. Not in great detail.
Mad golden topics.
Points,
do it,
you can kind of go with that. All right? So that's what we're going to do. All right? Anyway, Asada Shakur. Let's start with Asada Shakur, okay? Now, Asada Shakur, I didn't read the book. The book was like, I'm too lazy to read all that, all right? Furthermore, I don't know what happened. I don't know what transpired on that night. I don't know who necessarily shot the cop. I don't get into all that, okay? All I know is that her comrades broke her out of jail and decided that they were going to send her down to Cuba. Now, let's put all this in context. Given the context of the time, given the number of black men who are now being exonerated, who might have served 30, 40 years in jail for crimes that they
committed.
Given that I myself was arrested 3 times in 40 days on trumped up charges and had to spend $10,000, and if it wasn't for Abdul Aleem Muhammad sending money to bail me out, they would have had me for 3 years. Given that that actually happened to me, okay? That they actually bought evidence in the courtroom and they commingled evidence that was not mine with my stuff. given that that actually happened to me, okay? And given that this was like 1960, nobody was getting fair trial, and they had these people's comrade in a basement. Now, I know some of you.
Go to the big show, James Powell. You killed him, brother. I don't know that kind of kryptonite. Let's go.
I know my baby didn't do this. I know my mother didn't do this. I know my aunt didn't do this. Okay? But, what they decided to do was, you know why a girl ain't do it?
You don't want to see another wig when the AK-47 starts to spread. Beside, your gangsta grill, boy, they're too pretty.
Yeah,
and ain't no dentist in the mortuary. Keep on talking, you gon' get 26 inches on your hood. Bishop try to bring you back with a Bible verse. Shell's gonna make you
the best mac and cheese. Everybody ladies love deserves their mac and cheese.
Revolutionary gun heads in the air with a high beam on it, make you feel like deer. They say I'm all about peace. Why I carry a piece? Cause I'll be damned if y'all shoot me with the same bullet y'all shot Kennedy. Same bullet shot Martin in the balcony. Same bullet traveled to India and shot Gandhi. Same bullet shot John Lennon.
Happy Mother's Day. Keep it going. The Golden Universe Lake come at you. Yeah, the shine gold on your pants.
See you where the heavens dwell. It's the same bullets that's gonna send your ass to hell. Walk away. I heard him say you should walk away. You don't wanna see another wig when the AK-47 start to spread. Beside, your gangsta grill, boy, they're too pretty. Yeah, and ain't no dentist in the mortuary. Keep on talking, you gon' get 26 inches on your hearse. Bishop try to bring you back with a Bible verse. Alligator skin, Corvette, color cream. Got swag with the lean, haters with the beam. So scopes on my beam, X-Men Wolverine. Shit out of key, cause I'm a superhero being. Super fly, welcome to the fast life. Where before the song is over, somebody gon' die tonight. Yeah, I envision somebody thinking they too bad. You gon' go from too bad to shoot out of a bag. Before you talk, think about your words. Why you think I twitch so much? I love shooting birds. You know the difference with me and you, Ranger? I live it and you talk gangster. Walk away. I heard him say you should walk away. You don't want to see another way.
Yo, 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 this is King Midas and you're listening to the Golden Show. It's King Midas certified.
Golden. Keep on talking, you gon' get 26 inches on your hearse. Bishop try to bring you back with a Bible verse.
But it's too late, and it's too late. Face powdered up at the wake, boy, it's
too
late.
Everybody.
Yeah, it's too late, boy, it's too late.
Baby, mama crying now.
Go to the debate show. Debate when we go to the universe. You know the vamps don't.
I never seen a man cry till I seen a man die. It's too late.
Get that
trust
mac and
me,
cheese, everybody.
You don't want to talk reckless. Your head is start spinning like the lady from The Exorcist. Yeah, and don't talk no further. All my goons are named Uncle Murder. Heard her? Yeah. A place that they call Flatbush. Reason they call it Flatbush. Police come.
Down
get
there,
flat, push the
catacombs.
Bush in the bush.
There's
one
other guy
bag, your
look
brains
like.
Can
I
get
don't
gush.
Know.
Shh.
Just don't make no sense.
And we moved
about
to
it.
Jersey, where I picked up my swag and became a battle MC. Yeah, that's when I started on my grind.
What's gone wrong? Well, three words. The jazz stream. It has gone wrong. That's what we're saying. So Dr. Liz Benzies, as she is the founder of the Weather Club at the Royal Meteorological
Mac and
Society, and she should know good morning to you.
Good morning.
Is that oversimplifying a little bit?
Well, no, actually, you're right. The position of the jet stream is way far south than it would normally be at this time of year. And what that's led to is an area of high pressure that's dominating Northern Europe's weather.
Just give us 10 seconds before we go on. What is the jet stream?
Okay, very simply, it's a narrow band of very strong winds that sits about 30,000 feet above our heads, so way above high in the atmosphere where the planes fly around. And it's produced because of the difference in temperature between the equator and the poles, and where there's a bigger difference in temperature, a bigger contrast in that temperature, we get stronger winds called the jet stream.
Right, okay, so that is the jet stream. And what should it do?
Well, the jet stream tends to move from west to east across the Atlantic and brings in our weather systems. It's the real driving force of our weather systems. So it develops areas of low pressure and weather fronts that come in and bring us the wind and rain. And at the moment, it's sitting much, much further south across parts of the Mediterranean, southern Mediterranian.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Hello, everybody.
Science. Well, part of that is why the jet stream's out of position. It was out of position last summer as well.
The golden show is over. So now it's time to say goodbye to the golden family.
And they
Liquid gold.
Could well be this discussion.
Hello, everybody.
The changing solar activity over the last few years has had an impact on moving that jet stream. And then there's natural variability within our climate, and we see that over hundreds and thousands of years. So I think there's probably a combination of a few things going on here.
Oh dear, I want to ask you for the solution to this.
Okay. If only I had
science. Science. Okay. Shut up,
Liquid gold.
That mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.